Speak Indo Podcast is a medium to think about life while learning about the Indonesian language and culture. Hi, I'm Natasha, the host of Speak Indo Podcast. The first part of the story will be narrated in the Indonesian language. The second part will be in English. The transcript is available on our blog, speakindo.life, and our YouTube, Speak Indo channel. Season 3, Episode 6, Biak, Debris of War.
Lantunan senandung lirih dalam bahasa Jepang terdengar jelas dalam Gua Binsari. Sekumpulan peziarah asal Jepang tengah menyanyikan kidung penghormatan atas arwah para pahlawan mereka. Demikian satu peristiwa yang terjadi di Biak, Papua, September 2017 lalu. Tidak sedikit peziarah Jepang yang datang ke pulau ini hadir di Pulau Nun Timur Indonesia untuk mengirimkan doa pada kakek, ayah, kakak, adik, atau saudara mereka yang gugur di medan perang. Biak menjadi saksi betapa perang antara Jepang dan Amerika Serikat menelan korban yang tidak sedikit itu memilukan banyak hati. Waktu saya di Jepang, saya sempat bertemu langsung dengan salah satu keluarga korban perang, Nobu Teru Iwabuchi. Saksi kunci asal Iwate, Jepang ini mengungkap bagaimana perjuangannya menemukan kebenaran nasib sang ayah yang pergi berperang hingga mendorongnya membantu keluarga pejuang lainnya untuk dapat mengembalikan jasad-jasad korban perang tersebut kembali ke Jepang dan mendapatkan penghormatan yang layak dari negara. Pertempuran Biak berperan di dalam upaya pembebasan Filipina 75 tahun yang lalu antara Jepang dan Amerika Serikat. Dahsyatnya pertempuran itu masih bisa dirasakan dari keberadaan puing-puing perang dan tulang belulang yang masih bertebaran di sepanjang pulau. Meninggalkan pekerjaan rumah yang berat bukan hanya kepada kedua negara yang berperang, tapi juga Indonesia sebagai pemilik wilayah, terutama warga Biaknya sendiri yang mengalami trauma. Tercatat, sampai tahun 2015, lebih dari 19.570 tulang belulang tentara telah dipulangkan ke Jepang. Ini menjadi aksi kemanusiaan terbesar yang pernah dilakukan Indonesia dari bumi cendrawasih Papua. Tapi sayang sekali ya, Battle of Biak itu tidak pernah terdengar oleh banyak orang dan luput dari pelajaran sejarah tentang peran penting Papua dan Indonesia pastinya dalam kancah Perang Pasifik. Saya berharap sekolah-sekolah lebih giat dalam membangun kesadaran yang tinggi akan dampak sebuah perang bagi peradaban manusia, hingga jangan sampai terulang kembali di masa yang akan datang. Biak begitu indah, pantai biru, pasir putih, dan pecahan ombak yang luar biasa ini sayang untuk disia-siakan. Biak bisa menjadi tempat pembelajaran dan pariwisata. Dengan melihat zona perang yakni Biak War Trail, Shipwreck, dan atraksi wisata ekoturisme lainnya seperti pariwisata yang berhubungan dengan budaya masyarakat dan aktivitas keseharian masyarakat dalam mengolah kebun, membuat ukiran, ataupun sebagai nelayan. Biak, bila ingat, akan kembali.
The next one will be the English version of the story. The soft hum of chanting in Japanese could be heard clearly inside the Binsari cave. A group of Japanese pilgrims were in the middle of singing an honorary ballad for the spirits of their heroes. Thus, one event that occurred in Biak, Papua in September 2017. Many Japanese pilgrims came to the island to be present in that eastern island of Indonesia to send their prayers for their grandfathers, fathers, brothers, or relatives who perished in the battle. Biak became the witness of how the battle between Japan and the United States of America consumed many lives, broke many hearts. When Effie was in Japan, she managed to meet face to face with one of the war victims' family, Nobuteru Iwabuchi. This key witness from Iwate, Japan, described his struggle to find out the fate of his father, who went to war, and also pushed him to help other soldiers' families to retrieve back the bodies of their loved ones, victims of the war, back to Japan to receive the deserving honor bestowed by their country. The Biak battle played a role in the effort to liberate the Philippines 75 years ago from Japan and the United States of America. How terrible the battle was could still be felt from the presence of the battle debris and the bones scattered throughout the island, leaving a heavy homework not just to both warring countries, but also to Indonesia as the landowner, specifically the traumatized Biak residents. It is recorded that up to 2015, more than 19,570 soldiers' remains have been returned to Japan. This was one of the biggest humanitarian actions that was done by Indonesia from the land of the Cendrawasih, Papua. It's a shame that not many people have heard about the Battle of Biak, and history lessons fail to teach the important role of Papua and Indonesia in the War of the Pacific. Evie hopes that schools will be more active in building the appropriate awareness of the impact of war on human civilization so that history will not repeat itself in the future. Biak, so beautiful with its blue beaches, white sands, and its mighty crashes of waves, should not be missed. Biak can be a place of study and tourism, opening up the area of the past battle zone, Biak War Trail, shipwreck, and other ecotourism attractions, such as those pertaining to the local culture and the daily activities of its people in tending their fields, creating carvings, or their lives as fishermen. Biak, memories will bring us back. This is a story from Evi Ariati Arbai, who is originally from Jakarta and currently resides there. She works as an ethnographer, author, and tour operator specialist. She has written books titled Biak Debris of War, Dani the Highlander, and Badui Locked in Time. More information about her can be found through her website, www.eviariatiarbai.com. As this is one of our editions, as we are still in the midst of the COVID-19 pandemic, we'd like to extend our deep condolences to those who have lost their loved ones. This is definitely a very difficult time for everyone, and we can only hope that soon we can all heal as nature flourishes. Probably one day when we look back, we learn that how valuable is the time that we have to hug our loved ones, to be kind to our fellow humans, and to thank the sun for shining upon us.
I'm Natasha, your host of Speak Indo Podcast, and we would like to thank our guest speakers for sharing their story. If you like the story, please share it with your friends and family. The transcript of the story is available at our blog speakindo.life and our YouTube Speak Indo channel. You can subscribe to our channel so that you won't miss any upcoming episodes.
These are our stories. What is yours?